Gandhi was asked, what kind of economic model are you proposing? And what Gandhi said was very interesting. He said, what can be made by hand should be made by hand. What can be made in a village should be made in a village. What can be made in a small industry should be made in small industry. Then he says, what cannot be made by hand, what cannot be made in a village, what cannot be made in a small industry can be made in big industries. So for him it was very clear that this division need to be followed. That even soap is made in big industries now. Shampoo is made in big industries now. Chappal is made in big industries now. Cloth is made in big industries now. So all that what can be made by hand is also taken away by big industries. So I think this production method, this way, the way we produce, is major reason why there is so much problem. Poverty, discrimination, disparity, and all this violence. The reason is we have a production method that is depriving millions of people from using their hand, and they are suffering because of poverty.
சுதந்திரத்துக்கு அப்புறமா நம்மளோட பொருளாதார கொள்கைகளை கொண்டு வரும்போது காந்தி முக்கியமான ஒரு நாலு விஷயம் சொல்லியிருக்காரு. என்னன்னா, நம்ம கையால் என்ன செய்ய முடியுமோ அது கையால் தான் செய்யணும். அந்த பொருட்களை இந்த கிராமத்தில் என்ன செய்ய முடியுமோ அந்த பொருட்களை கிராமத்தில் தான் விளைவிக்கணும். சின்ன இண்டஸ்ட்ரி, சின்ன தொழிற்சாலையில் என்ன செய்ய முடியுமோ சின்ன தொழிற்சாலையில் நம்ம செய்யணும். இதில் எழுதியிலையுமே முடியாத விஷயங்கள் மட்டும்தான் பெரிய தொழிற்சாலைக்கு போகணும் அப்படிங்கிற ஒரு விஷயத்தை முன்னிட்டு இருந்தார். ஆனால் இன்றைக்கி இந்த காலகட்டத்தில் பார்த்திங்கன்னா, ஒரு சாதாரண சோப்புலேருந்து செருப்புலேருந்து எல்லாமே பெரிய பெரிய நிறுவனங்கள்கிட்ட போயிடுச்சு. இதனால் என்ன ஆகுது அப்படின்னா, நம்மளோட சமூகத்தில் ஏற்றத்தாழ்வுகள் மிக அதிகமாகிடுது. இந்த மாதிரி இல்லாமல் இந்த பொருளாதாரம் வந்து சந்தை சார்ந்து மட்டுமே இல்லாமல் எல்லாருக்கும் எல்லாம் கிடைக்கணும் அப்படிங்கிற ஒரு பொருளாதார மாடலாக மாற்றணும் அப்படின்னு.
So about my work, my guru, you must have heard of Vinoba Bhave, right? So Vinoba Bhave said, we consider him as our guru, he said, the sky is for everyone, the rain is for everyone, the light of the sun is for everyone, so land should also be for everyone. If sky is for everyone, land is also for everyone. And he says, these are not given by nature. He says, it's by God. God has given us the sky, the nature, the sun, the moon. This doesn't belong to any multinational company. This doesn't belong to any government because it is not produced by government. So nature should belong to every child. If it is God's production, the God's creation, the land, water, sky and everything, it should belong to every child of God. So my concern was that why is that land doesn't belong to millions of people? Why land is in the hands of some and land doesn't belong to many? So like Suresh Bhai was telling you, I began early on to organize people, Adivasis and Dalit and other communities around this land issue. And I was pressurizing the government to bring about major changes in the land reform. Because I realized, I was working as Supreme Court Commissioner for some time, and I realized many Tamil laborers were under bondage in Madhya Pradesh, in Chhattisgarh, in Uttar Pradesh, in Rajasthan, because they had no land. They were migrant laborers finally ending up in stone quarries. So I was understanding that people who don't have land, they have no identity, they have no security, they have no dignity. So what can they do? So land reform was the major agenda I was trying to address. And even today, in spite of all the work that I did for so many years, I think land reform, land redistribution is very important issue in our country, and we need to work for it.